Now let's look at use cases in a little more detail and start by defining exactly what an actor is. An actor represents an entity, which can be a human or a device, that plays a role within my system, so that interacts with my system. Is some entity from the outside world with respect to my system that interacts with my system. It is important to clarify that an entity can play more than one role. For example, you might have somebody working in a bank that can be both an employee of the bank or a customer of the bank, depending on how it interacts with the banking system. And obviously, more than one entity can play the same role. Using the same example, we can have both an employee of the bank and just a regular customer playing the role of the customer. So again, it all depends on what the entity does, how the entity interacts with the system, what kind of functionality of the system the entity uses. And finally, actors may appear in more than one use case. So it's fairly normal for the same actor to interact with the system in different ways and therefore to appear in more than one use case. Just think about the use cases as scenarios of usage. If the same actor can interact with the system in different ways, that actor will appear in multiple use cases. Now let's go back to the description of our course management system and see how we can identify actors in the system. And as we did for the class diagram before, I encourage you to stop the video and try to identify the actors in the system yourself before I do it. If we look at the description, we can see that, for example, the registration manager is clearly an actor for the system. Students are actors for the system. Professors are actors for the system. And notice that we're not doing the same thing that we were doing when identifying classes. Here we are identifying entities that are from the outside world and have an active role in interacting with my system. Again, registration manager, that we will just call register for simplicity, students and professors. So once we have identified the actors for our example, we can simply draw them using the notation that we just introduced. So we have the registrar, and notice how for every actor, we clarify the role that the actor plays. We have the professor, and we have the student. So here, these are the three actors that we identified for our system.